look at each other as the child of God, as chosen by God, created by God for a purpose. So look at each other as the child of God, and it is there you can live your Christian life. Once I was told there was a lady who was cleaning the church, pouring water and removing the water, and a man, young man, who is an officer, he came behind and saw this beautiful lady, young lady, cleaning the church, sweeping the church and pouring it out water along with other volunteers and doing the work for the church. Then the young man felt such a beautiful lady is doing this menial job. Maybe she doesn't have a job or something. So when she was going back, he stopped her and said, "Madam, do you have a job?" She was about to say something. He said, "If you don't have, or if you need any help, you take mine." And he gave his card. And that lady gently took the card and kept it. "Thank you, sir," he said. "And do you have any address of yours or any card?" "Yes, sir. It is in my car." And she was moving towards the car. The young man said, "Car? You have a car?" So when he went behind, he saw that lady opening BMW car. You have a BMW car?" She opened the car and gave a card and said, "Thank you." And she went away. He took the card and found that she is the CEO of the company just opposite where he is working as an ordinary manager. He felt so ashamed, he ran away. He never came to the church anymore. Sometimes we look at the people, because she was cleaning the church, doing work for God, he thought she is an ordinary worker. But the reality is, though she was a CEO, she knew in the heart, "I am the child of God." She knew that I have to do something for God. Whether you are rich or poor, whatever may be your position, the basic thing that gives life to us is who we are to Christ. And with that truth, we have to live out our life. Otherwise, the world will eat us up. If you are not led by God, the world will lead you. If you are not blessing yourself with the truth of the gospel, the world with its tricks will destroy you. So, that's why we read in the book of Proverbs chapter 8, verse 35 to 36, "Love the Lord and you will find your life will be blessed." But if you do not have the Lord, you will be hurt. Because when you do not have the Lord, the evil will have you. The enemy will have you. Our hearts can never be empty. If you don't possess the Lord, if you don't hunger for the Lord, if you don't walk as the Lord designs us, the enemy will possess us and destroy us. In the gospel of today, that's what we find. Jesus is asking, "Who am I?" Different people give a different answer. Jesus is asking them, "Whom do you say that I am?" Peter responds saying, "You are the Christ." It's a beautiful confession of who Jesus is. Jesus says, "You hold on to this promise. And if you hold on to this promise, I tell you, you will be like a rock. And I will build my church. You hold on to this promise. Let anything happen." And then Jesus speaks about his death and resurrection. Peter could not believe. His idea of Jesus is, he is Christ, the Lord, the Savior. But the reality Jesus explains is, he has to go through death. He's not able to believe that. If he is Christ, how can he be thrown himself to death? How will he give himself into the hands of men to be crucified? We do not know how our God melts us, molds us, and uses us. God uses different methods. He brings different people in our lives. He brings different situations in our lives to melt us, mold us, and use us as beautiful persons. And today, Peter could not understand it. He is thinking Jesus is Christ. Christ means he should not suffer. And when Christ talks about suffering, he is not able to understand. And Jesus says, "Get behind me, Satan, because you are a block to me, then you are a blessing." It is not enough to serve God if you don't understand who God is. And if you don't live as the reality, we will be trying to live a focused life. Today, let's ask the Lord, "Lord, give me the conviction of who we are. You are my Christ. You are my Lord. You are my God. And whatever happens in my life, I will move on."